like God got a plan, you know what I'm saying, for like he got a different plan for everybody. So I just feel like, you know what I'm saying, boom, I get this behind me, I just, you know what I'm saying, go even bigger.
Let me tell y'all something. God got something in store for everyone individually. And what he got in store for most, he don't got in store for others. And you just basically have to, you know, that's just reality. And we have to realize life is like a game. You know, if you want level one, level two, level three, and past YouTubers have already made these videos, you know, about leveling up and about conquering each stage in life. And it's big question marks out here. And everybody wanna know the recipe for success, but what makes one person successful, it doesn't make the next one successful. But like Pimp C said, he said, man, y'all want to glorify the rap game and the gangster shit. And y'all want to glorify all this shit. And one thing about it is y'all telling these kids the good side of all this shit, the drug dealing and all this. And as far as what I'm talking about, as far as business, everybody see the good side, but ain't nobody talking about the bad side or the downside in this shit. You know what I'm saying? Because it's so systemically set up for everybody to want to be carbon copies of each other. And that's jealousy and envy. And that's what black people most definitely suffer from. So we think because our neighbor is doing it this way and he's successful in this way, maybe it's a story behind why he's successful. You know, maybe he already had wealth. But the main thing is we all have to conquer. And we have to persevere and we have to like in the game at the end of every level there's a boss that you have to beat, and you have to basically level up and keep leveling up and keep going to the next stage. But a success story, for every success story, there's probably a million stories where people wasn't successful, where they failed. So black people, what we got to understand is whatever God got in store for you, you got to realize that y'all got to realize that what he got in store for me, he might not got in store for you. You know what I'm saying? So basically it's just a lot of people out here that's carbon copies, and because they see the one person successful in one avenue, they think they're going to be successful in the same avenue. But if God don't got that intended for you, you're just not going to be successful at it. You got to find yourself and see what your purpose is on this earth. And our creator, he already knows who the haters are. He already knows who the malicious people are. Everybody is not meant to be at a certain level. It's just not meant to be like that. And you just have to face reality. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of people miss their blessings daily. A lot of people miss them, man. It's real life video game, man. And a lot of times you have to avoid all of these obstacles, and you gotta fight all these mini bosses before you get to the main boss. And that's just the main thing that a lot of black people's missing, man. We all can't be carbon copies, man. We all can't be entrepreneurs. We all can't have a business. It's not meant for all of us. This is America. It's not meant. This is a capitalist society. It's not meant. Somebody got to be the consumer, man. That's basically what I'm trying to say, man. But It's just so crazy out here, man, because the chosen ones sit out from the rest of them, man. It's just, man, I wish I had the answer to everyone's problems, but the only thing I can do is to be an example. of how God is working in my life. And that's all God wants you to do. He wants you to be an example. And then you'll start seeing your blessings and you won't miss them. Now, if you're missing your blessings, you know, you keep letting these opportunities and these windows close because you don't have visual insight. You're not seeing what God wants you to see, so you keep missing it. There's so many different opportunities out here. And if you're gonna open a business, man, you have to be an innovator. You have to set yourself apart from the rest of society, man. But society, basically, everybody is carbon copies. And as far as entrepreneurship and just things that blacks have endeavors in. But if you look around in society, man, and if you take a map and you look at the bigger picture, what do blacks really solely, rightly own? That's the thing. Take a map of your nearest town where you live at and put a dot everywhere there's a black business, and then put a dot where everywhere's a white business. You know what I'm saying? But I mean, if you won't take a gamble and take a chance, because everything in life is a gamble. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of people that goes to the gambler boat, I mean the casino, and for where everything you're trying to get, guess what? This person hits the jackpot in one try. And they make right in that one jackpot, they make everything that you've been trying to make your whole life. That's why it's called hitting the jackpot, hitting the lottery. You know what I'm saying? So basically, it's only a few people visually that you see that's successful, and then it has everybody else envying them. That's the main thing, man. That's the main thing. But what God got in store for one person, He don't got in store for the next person. You have to find your niche in life. It's called finding yourself.
Alright guys, so we just got word that Buddy is outside, so it is officially time for us to make our move. And look, bruh, I feel sorry if you outside with Buddy, because anybody that's standing next to him is getting it too. So I devised a plan. My homegirl gonna pull up and ask for directions, or you know, just some sort of small talk. And as soon as Buddy least expected, I promise you, I'm up in that AR and I'm nailing everybody out there.
Can one of you two help me?
All right, baby, how you doing? I'm Power Road, you see where you at. Anyway, where you need to go, baby, I can help you out.
Okay, I'm trying to get to.
Before you say anything, after this conversation, I'm gonna need directions to your kitty cat, because you looking righteous.